Thank you for worshiping with us at Jackson Chapel CME Church, located at 418 Water Street in Courtland, Alabama, where our pastor is Reverend David T. Young, Sr. Please join our service already in progress.
Give God a hand clap of praise this morning. As we come into worship, truly God has been good to us. He has brought us from a mighty, mighty long way. For I'm glad today to be in the house of the Lord. The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silent before him. For this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. For the psalmist said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. For this is our call to worship, and let us govern ourselves accordingly. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. At this time, we will have our opening selection from the choir.
Yeah.
hopes on things eternal.
Yes. Yes.
Hold to God's unchanging hand.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Let us now stand and let us unite ourselves in the historical confession of our Christian faith. What is that we believe? I believe in God the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended to heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated. Reverend Jones will lead us in prayer.
Shall we pray? Father, I stretch my hand to thee. No other help that I know. If thou shalt withdraw thyself from thee, master, whither shall we go? Bread of heaven, bread of heaven. Feed us till we want no more. I don't believe you brought us this far just to leave us. I don't know why we have to cry sometimes. But Lord, we understand it better by and by.
Yes.
Gracious God, our fathers, again, we come just to say much obliged. Thank you for all the things you have done for us.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, we thank you for letting us lay down last night.
Yes.
And soon this morning, you touched our body.
Yes.
And leave our lives to roll on a little while longer.
Yes.
Lord, we just want to say thank you.
Yes.
And Father, like the old folks, you said, when we got up this morning, we had the right activity of our limbs.
Yes.
We had eyes that we can see.
Yes.
We had legs, Father, that we can walk. And we have a tongue that we can thank you for all the blessings you have bestowed upon us. Now, Lord, you have given us enough sense to know that we in all ways did right. There are things you told us not to do while we were disobedient, and we did it anyway. There are things you told us to do, Father, and we were so hard-headed we did not do them. So we come like David came at you to create us a clean heart and renew the right spirit within us. Lord, we thank you, Father, for your Son, Jesus, who gave his life that we might live, Father. Lord, as you look down upon this church in a special way, bless our pastor, Father, you have laid over here, Father.
Bless, Lord.
Continue to lead and guide him in the way you have him to go, Father. Lord, we bless every auxiliary that represents his body, Father. And Lord, we just want to say thank you for a good old time religion, Father. Father, one that we don't have to be ashamed of. We thank you, God, for thanking the well as it is. Some of us might have a little sickness in our body, but we know you're a doctor, Father, and never lost a patient. Somebody might be like me, might be a mother of a child, but I know you'll be a mother for the motherless. You'll be a father for the fatherless. And when you get lonely, you'll be a company keeper, Father. Lord, we thank you for the little bread we had to eat this morning. Thank you for every sip of water that we drank this morning. Thank you for the clothes that you put on our backs, Father. Lord, we have so much to be thankful for. If we have 10,000 tongues, we still can thank you enough. But Lord, we just want to say thank you anyway for all the things you have done for us. And Master, if you don't do anything else, you have done enough. And Father, able to keep on like the song saying, hold unto your unchanging hand. Because you said you'll never leave us, nor will you forsake us. And Lord, we believe your word because you said it, Father. And we count that what you say is true, Heavenly Father. Bless the man of God that's going to stand and preach your word, Father. Abraham the preacher, some lost soul come crying. What must I do to be saved? And Lord, we thank you. We bless your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Whatever you need, all you got to do is ask God, and He'll give it to you. Is that right?
Amen.
We thank God today for His blessings. This time we're going to read a passage of Scripture. If you would, turn your attention to the first chapter of the book of Acts. Acts chapter 1. And we're going to begin with verse number 4. If you found it, please acknowledge it by saying amen.
Amen.
And being assembled together with them, Jesus commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which says he, you have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days from now. When they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the time or the seasons which the Father has put in his own power, but you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. And you shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth. And when he had spoken these things, while they beheld, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. And while they looked steadfastly toward heaven as he went up, behold, two men stood by them in white apparel, which also said, ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven, shall so come in like manner as you have seen him go into heaven. This is God's word for God's people. And the people of God said,
amen,
amen, amen, amen, and amen.
Amen.
Amen. At this time, we're going to prepare for our offering. As we prepare to lift our offering, the Bible says to let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. For the Lord loves a cheerful giver. For remember the words of the Lord when he said that it's more blessed to give than to receive. Just be mindful that no matter how much we give, we can't beat God's giving, no matter how we try. Amen. I feel better. Dear eternal God, our Father, we thank you now for allowing us to give a portion of what you have given unto us. Father, we realize we are able to give because of every blessing that you have bestowed upon us. Oh, Father, we know that everything that we have belongs to you. So we ask, Father, now that you will take these, our gifts, bless them, Father, make them what you would have them to be. For we know, Father, that it will be pressed down, shaken together, and running over if you wave your hands across it. We say thank you right now in advance. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. And the people of God said, amen. Amen. King Jesus, I don't need nobody else. That's all right with me. I hope it's all right with you. Amen. Let me say that one more time. It's all right with me. I hope it's all right with you. Amen. Amen. We are grateful today just to be in the land of the dying, on our way to the land of the living. Amen. This is just a little temporary place. But the reason why we assembled here today, we're making preparation for that new place. Is that right? Amen. We give honor to our Heavenly Father today on this first Sunday in the month of May. We thank God for just being here. We give honor to his only begotten son, Jesus the Christ, whom we continue to celebrate because of who he is. Somebody says, as long as I got King Jesus, amen. And we give honor to his precious Holy Spirit, who is our sustainer, for he keeps us in times such as these, amen. We give honor to these preachers here today, Reverend Bankhead and Reverend Jones, and to Reverend Grissom in his absence. He wasn't feeling well this morning. And to Reverend Napier and Reverend Lawson Fletcher, and to all of those God's people. And I want to say this before I get started now, because when I was sitting there this morning, I was kind of shaking in my boots, so to speak. Because I told Robert Young, I said, man, Brother Robert Orr almost preached my sermon this morning. Amen. But we thank God for our Sunday school teacher this morning. Let's give him a hand. He need to have a birthday every Sunday. Amen. But we thank God for him, and we're thankful for his family for being here today to help him to celebrate his birthday. Amen. And again, we are just thankful just to be here on this day. But there is a word. Amen. There is a word from the second chapter of the book of Acts. Beginning at verse number 14. And we're going to read through verse number 21. Acts chapter number 2, verses 14 through 21. When you have found this, please acknowledge it by saying amen. Amen. And the scripture reads, but Peter, standing up with the 11, lifted up his voice and said unto them, ye men of Judea, and all ye that dwell at Jerusalem, be this known unto you, and hearken to my words. For these are not drunken, as ye suppose, seeing it is but the third hour of the day. But this is that which was spoken by the prophet Joel. And it shall come to pass in the last days, says God, I will pour out of my spirit upon all flesh. Yes. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy.
Yes.
And your young men shall see visions.
Yes.
And your old men shall dream dreams. And on my servants and on my handmaidens, I will pour out in those days of my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show wonders in heaven above, and signs in the earth beneath, blood and fire and vapor of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness, and the moon into blood, before that great and notable day of the Lord come. And it shall come to pass, y'all listen to this, that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. God's word for God's people. And the people of God said,
amen.
Amen. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for yet another opportunity to be able to stand before these your people and break the bread of life.
Thank you, Lord.
Father, I ask now that you will grant your preaching power. For I realize that little old me can't do anything without big old you. Father, have your way now. Give me the strength to be able to stand before your folk. For it's not about us, but it's all about you. Touch the hearts of these your people, that their hearts will be changed, and they will no longer be conformed, but will be transformed by the renewing of their mind. I ask you now to let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight. For you, Lord, are my strength, and you are my redeemer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 And amen.
Amen.
Today is a new day. Is that right? Today is a day that you've never seen. Neither will you ever see again. Just this week or this past week, I was having a conversation with someone. And one of the things mentioned was that time waits on no one. Have to be for the right now, for tomorrow is not promised. But one thing that we can all agree on, that anything worth having is worth waiting for. Am I right? So I want to talk to us today for just a few moments on the thought, just waiting on Jesus. Just waiting on Jesus. Time is the indefinite continued process of existence. And events that occur in an apparently irreversible succession from the past, through the present, and into the future. Time transcends our wildest imagination. In the past, we have heard statements such as time waits on no one, or just in time, or now isn't the time, or it's time to get up, or it's time to lay down, or it's time to clock in, or it's time to clock out. We have heard time. Is that right? And sometimes I recognize when I'm traveling the highways of life, I often notice that several vehicles, including mine, sometimes travel at different speeds. Mm-hmm. And I often thought about that person that would fly past me, mm-hmm. running at I don't know what speed, but, and then when I get to the stoplight, that same person that zoomed by me is sitting there at that light. So I realize there's a relationship between where they are going and what time they have to get there, but even at the same time, they cannot, or we cannot, control time. I heard Brother Robert mention this morning that Jesus told his disciples that his ways are not our ways. Oh, isn't it strange that there are certain times that we are, or we feel that we are in control of time, and other times we have no clue on what tomorrow is going to bring. So, since we have illustrated, I want to ask you a question. Have you ever wondered why you are still here? Have you ever thought about the reason why Jesus has left you here? Well, I want us to look at the text and how there was an assembly of people that had the same mind and the same goal. Jesus had appointed them to go to the upper room and wait on the promise. Is that right? And could you imagine if we would come to church and just wait on Jesus? Oh, Lord, have mercy. If we would just come and wait on Jesus and see what Jesus will do when he shows up. Amen. See, a lot of times he show up and some of us miss him. Oh, I wish I had somebody. Have you ever wondered why? Or is there a reason why we have been given more time? In the book of Genesis, chapter 18, verses 26 through 33, it tells of a conversation that the Lord had with Abraham. He said, I'm going to destroy the cities. And Abraham asked God, well, let me go and see if anybody will repent, and I don't want you to destroy it. He said, well, tell you what. Abraham said, if there be 50, will you still destroy the city? He went to Jackson Chapel looking for 50. I wish I had somebody. And he could not find 50, so he went back. And the Lord, what about 40? went to First Baptist and couldn't find 40. Lord have mercy. Then 30, then 20, then 10. Could you imagine that if somebody there had been waiting on Jesus, there could have been some folk that was saved? In other words, Abraham was trying to negotiate some time. Lord, just give him more time. Have you ever wondered why, Ronnie, why he's still giving us more time? He's looking for some folk that are ready to change their ways. Amen. The Bible says that he's coming back and he's looking for a church without spot or wrinkle. He didn't say nothing about no building. He didn't say nothing about no denomination. But he said he's looking for some true believers, like was sitting there in that upper room on the day of Pentecost, somebody that knew what it meant to have a relationship with God. In our text, it tells that there's a time approaching. Peter said it shall come to pass. Is that what he said? He said, it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. But I want us to back up just for a moment. Because something had happened while they were there. Those folk that really did believe, even though they were afraid, they still was waiting on Jesus. Oh, Lord, have mercy. And it says in the beginning of that chapter, and when the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all with one accord and in one place, and suddenly, y'all better watch out. Keep setting that plan. He said, and suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a mighty rushing wind, and it filled the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongue like as a fire, and set on each of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. Wait a minute. Hold on. And it says that it filled the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongue like as a fire, and it sat upon each of them. And in my Bible here it says, and they were all, and then underlined, filled. And then it said with the Holy Ghost, and began to, and it underlined, speak. Then it filled with other tongues, and it underlined, tongue. But I'm telling us today that sometimes if we would just wait on Jesus, things that we don't understand will come into fruition. It may not be what you think it should be, but I dare you to understand that it will be the way God wants it to be. It talks about all the different folk. The Parthians and the Medes and the Elamites and the Mesopotamians and the Judeans and the Cappadocians and Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia and Egypt and all the parts of Libya and Cyrene and strangers of Rome, Jews and proselytes. Reverend Bank had all kind of folk. Let me make it plain in layman terms. Poor folk. Rich folk, low folk, high folk, black folk, white folk, brown folk, blue folk, green. Oh, yeah, I wish I had somebody. But it said that all was together and it fell on all of them. And something about that name Jesus, when you wait on Jesus, he has a tendency to show up. It said that all these folk were amazed, but others doubted. Well, I'm just so glad that we don't have no doubters today. I'm glad everybody believe. I'm glad everybody know who he is. I'm glad everybody can sing that song that I'm just waiting on Jesus, and I know my waiting day will soon be over. But they were amazed. Somebody say, what meaning? What's going on with this? Well, others mocking said these men were full of new wine. You know, there's always going to be some naysayers. There are always going to be some folk that say that this can't be. But just like back then, there got to be somebody. Which gets us to our text. But Peter, you know the one that said that he would never leave Jesus. The same Peter that said that he would never deny. The same Peter that cut off the soldier's ear. The same Peter. The same Peter that couldn't outrun John. Y'all know the Peter I'm talking about. That same Peter, standing up with the 11, lifted up his voice. And he said, ye men of Judea, and all ye that dwell at Jerusalem, be this known unto you, and hearken to my words. For these are not drunken as you suppose. In other words, he said, you know that there's a certain time that we drink. And it's only 9 a.m. in the morning. It's only the third hour of the day. See, the day begins at 6. But it was only the ninth hour. The third hour of the day. Which being 9 a.m. But this is what was spoken by the prophet Joel. And it shall come to pass in the last days, said God, that I will pour out of my spirit in the last days. I'm going to pour out my spirit. Somebody say, in the last days, I'm going to pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Those that said they wouldn't go, going to still have to go. The one that you didn't want to go, they still going to go. The one that you said you remember when, they going to be the ones to go. But he said that your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. And your young men shall see visions. And your old men shall dream dreams. On my servants and on my handmaidens, I will pour out in those days of my spirit. And they all shall prophesy. I will show wonders in heaven. And I will show signs in the earth beneath. Blood, fire, and vapor of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness. And the moon be turned into blood. Before that great and notable day of the Lord come. But what I like about it, if you wait on Jesus. If you wait on Jesus. My Bible says it shall come to pass. That whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Ain't God all right? I've got to look back, y'all, for just a minute of your time. If you remember in the first chapter of Acts, when Jesus had just completed giving the Great Commission, ain't God all right? My Bible tells me that he told them to go back and wait on the promise of God. Wait on the promise. What I'm talking about is waiting on Jesus. Ain't God all right? If you wait on him, you shall receive power. Ain't God all right? For truly,
truly John baptized with water, but when the promise comes, he will baptize you with fire and the Holy Ghost. Ain't God all right? Not many days from now, I wanna wonder how somebody's there. We're just waiting on Jesus. Ain't going all right. I'm getting ready now. I'm getting ready to leave you alone. But I want you to know today that when they were standing there, this is my favorite part. While they were standing there, looking up to heaven, two men in white apparel were standing there, looked at them, asked them a question, why are you standing there looking into heaven? That same Jesus that they hung up on Calvary, that same Jesus that hung there from his name, ain't God all right? That same Jesus that they pierced him in his side, that same Jesus that blood came raining down, that same Jesus that looked at Mary and said, behold your son, that same Jesus that looked at John and said, behold your mother, that same Jesus, that same Jesus, that same Jesus, the same Jesus that their father forgive them, for they know not what they do. That same Jesus, that same Jesus, that say it's finished. That same Jesus, that same Jesus, that went down in a bottle or two. That same Jesus, that same Jesus, that got up early that Saturday morning. That same Jesus, that same Jesus, that went down with 40 days. That same Jesus, that same Jesus, that he's the same way, the same way, the same way that he went up. He's coming back again. Just wait on him. Just wait on Jesus. That same Jesus that died for your sin. Just wait on him. If you're going through troubles, I dare you to wait on Jesus. If you got sickness in your body, I dare you to wait on Jesus. Let me give you one witness, and I'll leave you alone. For 12 years, this woman had an issue of blood. She had went to every doctor, went everywhere trying to find something, but couldn't find anything. But one day, she heard. One day she heard. One day she heard. One day she heard about that same Jesus, the one that gave sight to the blind. She heard about that same Jesus that made the lame walk. She heard about that same Jesus that made the dumb talk, the same Jesus. She said, if I could just touch the hem of his garment, I know that I will be made whole. She reached out. It took her 12 years, but she reached out. She touched the hem of his garment. And the Bible says, Jesus says, somebody, oh Lord, have mercy. Said somebody. Yeah. Have you ever touched him? He said, somebody, yeah, touch me. Yeah. And you know how we are sometimes. The disciples say, shoot, yeah. You know somebody gonna touch all these folk out here. Surely somebody, what you talking about, man? Surely somebody gonna touch you. Jesus said, no, you don't understand. This touch, when I was touched, my virtue left me. In other words, when she touched what Jesus had, transformed into her, and she was healed. Oh, I dare you to wait on him. I dare you to wait on him. And when he comes, don't run from him. Oh, I wish I had somebody. Just waiting on Jesus. And guess what happened? It said a lot of folk. What did you say, 3,000? Good God, from Zion. And y'all think two or three, but 3,000 in the same day. Amen. Lord have mercy. If we wait on Jesus, time is of the essence.
Yes, it is.
We have to get ready right now.
Yes.
Because that's why we're here.
Amen.
It's prepare for his return.
Yes.
He said, behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me.
Amen.
But I want, you know, I love all of the promise that Jesus made. But we have to understand something. If we are not prepared, we're not going to receive the promise. Brother Robert said this morning, he said, if you don't go there, you're going to hell.
Yeah.
Plain a day. There's only two choices.
Yeah.
There's only two choices. See, ain't, you know, you either go up or down. Ain't going to be no left, no right. It's only going to be two choices. So, if we wait on him, he has a promise.
Amen.
He said, you shall receive power.
Yes.
After that, the Holy Ghost has come upon you.
Amen.
If you don't have the Holy Ghost, you are P-O-W-E-R-L-E-S-S. Do I need to spell that again? P-O-W-E-R-L-E-S-S. You are powerless. There's nothing you can do unless the Holy Spirit be with you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. May God bless you. It's our prayer. At this time, we're going to open the doors of the church. And as we open the doors of the church, there may be someone here today that don't know the Lord and the pardon of their sins and are ready to accept Christ as their personal Lord and Savior. You may come today by letter. You may come by Christian experience, or you may come as a candidate to baptism. However you come, come humbling yourself before God, giving God your heart. And stop asking what you can do for God, but ask yourself, what can God do for you? Because no matter how much we do, we can't never do enough.
Amen.
But I believe Paul said in the book of Romans, we ought at least give the least our reasonable service. That's what that means. Give reasonable. God don't ask us for a lot, but we give him less than what he asked for.
Amen.
And we ought to be ashamed of ourselves. So if there be anyone today, the doors are open. We bid you come. There may be someone today who's looking for a church home, and you want Jackson Chapel to be your place of worship. We accept you as well. This is the day you can make your confession. You may have already been baptized, and you have already confessed your faith, but you're looking for a place of worship. So this invitation is for you as well. If there be any, let them come. There be any today. If not, we have done what the Lord requires of us. Amen.
God is
my head, my head.
Know that God is your everything. If you don't know, you ought to know that God is your everything. He said it in his own words. He said, I'm the Alpha and the Omega. He said, I'm the beginning and the end. He said, I'm the first and the last. Amen. Or some old preacher used to say, he's so high you can't go over him. He's so low you can't go under. He's so wide you can't go around him. So you need to know that he's your everything. Amen. Amen. We thank God for this choir today. And at this time, we're going to prepare for our service of Holy Communion to go ahead and to celebrate, guess who? That same Jesus. Amen. That same Jesus. As we give the invitation, let us prepare our hearts and our minds for this Holy Communion. The Bible said, let each man look at his own self or their own self, not as of anybody else's righteousness, but your own righteousness. Examine your own self. Yes. Amen. For we are not to judge one or the other, but we are to look at ourselves. As we prepare to come to the Lord's table, ye that do truly and earnestly repent of your sins, are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God, draw near with faith. And I know we won't be coming to the altar, but we want you to take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your own humble confession to Almighty God. Amen. 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 Our general confession. Almighty God, Father our Lord Jesus Christ, make of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, and providing most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may hereafter serve and please thee in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Let the church say, amen. O Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who thy great mercies and promise forgiveness of sins to all them that with hearty repentance and true faith turn to thee,
Have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins, and confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and bring us to everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trust in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We're not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs of thy table, but thou art the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful souls and bodies may be made clean by his death and washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. And the people of God said, amen. The prayer of consecration. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, whose our tender mercy did give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption who made there, by his oblation of himself once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction of the sins of the whole world, and then instituted in his holy gospel, commanded us to continue in perpetual memory of that his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father. We most humbly beseech thee, and grant that we receive in these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ's holy institution. In remembrance of his death and passion, we may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to the disciples, saying, take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after the supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave to them, saying, drink ye all of this. For this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many, for the remission of sins. Do this as often as you shall drink it in remembrance of me. And the people of God said, amen. Amen. At this time, the ministers and I will take the Holy Sacrament. My brothers and sisters, the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, which was given for us, let us take it and eat together, feasting upon in our heart. Now let us take the cup, the blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ that was shed for us for the remission of sins. Let us take it and drink together, feasting upon in our heart. And let us pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thine kingdom and come, thine will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil, for thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. And now, my brothers and sisters, you are now ready to partake of the body. You see before you the bread, which represents the body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ that were given for you. Will you all take it now and eat together, feasting upon in your heart. Now we take the cup. The blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we will shed it for you for the remission of sins. We all take it and drink together, feasting upon your heart. The church say, amen. Amen. O Lord, our Heavenly Father, we thy humble servant desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this hour with sacrifices of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and thy whole church may obtain remission of sins. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls, and our bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice.
humbly beseeching thee that all we who have been partakers of this holy communion may be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction. And although we be unworthy through our manifold sin to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee. O Father Almighty, world without end. And the people of God say it. Amen. Amen. And amen. Sure to come. Amen. Amen.
I hope you have enjoyed our service with Pastor David T. Young, and we'll see you next week at the same time. May God bless you.